Hello friends, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. We are going to discuss a tutorial on credit analysis topic. Credit analysis. In layman terms, credit analysis is more about identification of what? Of risk in situation where a potential for lending is observed by the banks. Both quantitative and qualitative assessment forms a very part of the overall appraisal of the clients in terms of companies and individuals. So this in general helps to determine the entity's debt servicing capacity or its ability to repay. In this particular tutorial, we are going to look at credit analysis from beginner's point of view. Now, what is credit analysis? See, credit analysis is basically a process of drawing conclusions from available data. It can be both qualitative and quantitative regarding the credit worthiness of the entity and making recommendations regarding the perceived needs and risk. So credit analysis is also concerned with the identification and evaluation and mitigation of the risk associated with an entity's failing to meet financial commitments. Let's understand the credit analysis process. Now, below is the diagram that shows the overall credit analysis process. It starts from proposal, then inspection is done, and then financial scrutiny and market review. Post that scenario, there is a presentation of the proposal that is done and it has been pitched. The sanction of the assessment after screening out various things which are important enough. The data collation is done, any analysis of various parameters or any nitty-gritties that needs to be followed. A credit rating is done, presentation for the sanctions, and if there are any cancellations and things that needs to be added, and all has been done. Some terms and conditions which needs to be pitched in, because if that will be form a part of it, so that any conflict of interest can be avoided. And then for a final thing is the approval of the process. So what does a credit analyst look for? See, ever wondered why bankers ask so many questions and make you will feel so many forms when you apply for a loan? Don't some of them feel intrusive and repetitive, and whole process of submission of various documents seems cumbersome? You just try to fathom as to what they do with all this data and what they are actually trying to ascertain. It is definitely not only your deadly charm and attractive personality that makes you a good potential borrower. Obviously, there is more to that particular story. So here we'll try to get an idea about what exactly a credit analyst is looking for. So it is bifurcated into the 5 C's. The first C is going to be the character. Now this character, this is a part where the general impression of the protective borrower is analyzed. The lender forms a very subjective opinion about the trust worthiness of the entity to repay its loan. Discrete inquiries and background and experience level, market opinion and various other sources can be by way to collect qualitative information, and then an opinion can be formed whereby he can take a decision about the character of the entity. The second C is called the capacity. The capacity over here refers to the ability of the borrower to service the loan from the profit generated by the investments. Now this is perhaps the most important of the 5 factors. The lenders will calculate exactly how the repayment is supposed to take place and cash flows from the business, from the timing of payment, of repayment and probability of the successful repayments of the loan, and payment of history, and such other factors are considered to arrive at probable capacity of the entities to repay the loan. So the first C was character, the second was capacity, the third is capital. Now, the capital is the borrower's own skin in the business. This is seen as the proof of the borrower's commitment to the business. This is an indicator how much the borrower is at risk if the business fails, and lenders expect a decent contribution from the borrower's own asset and personal financial guarantee to establish that they have committed their own funds before asking for their funding. So good capital goes on to strengthen trust between the lender and the borrower. The next is the collateral or the guarantees. The collateral are the form of security that the borrower provides to the lender to appropriate the loan in case it is not repaid from the return as established at the time of availing the facility. Guarantees, on the other hand, are the documents promising the repayment of the loan from someone else, generally from family members or friends. If the borrower fails to repay the loan, getting adequate collateral or guarantee as may deem fit to cover partly or wholly the loan amount bears huge significance. So this is a way to mitigate the default risk. Many a times collateral security is also used to offset any distasteful factors that may have come to forefront during the assessment process. Conditions that describes the purpose of the loan I mean, that's the last thing, the conditions. That last C, condition describes the purpose of the loan as well as the terms under which the facility is sanctioned. Purposes can be working capital, purchases of additional equipment, inventory, or for long-term investment. So the lender considers various factors such as macroeconomic conditions, currency positions, and industry health before putting forth the condition for the facilities. Let's analyze the credit analysis case study. From the time immemorial, there has been an eternal conflict between the entrepreneur, business, and bankers regarding the quantification of the credit. The resentment on the part of the business owner arises when he believes that the bankers might not be fully appreciating his business requirement needs and might be underestimating the real scale of the opportunity that is accessible to him, provided he gets sufficient quantum of loan. However, the credit analyst might be having his own reasons to justify the amount of risk he's ready to bear, which may include bad experiences with that particular sector or his own assessment of the business requirements. Many a times, there are also internal norms or regulations which force the analyst to follow a more restrictive course. So the most important point to realize is that banks are in the business of selling money, and therefore the risk regulations and restraint are very fundamental to the whole process. Therefore, the loan products available to the prospective customers, the terms and conditions set for availing the facility, and the steps taken by the bank to protect its assets against the default all have a very direct forbearance to the proper assessment of the credit facility. So let's have a look at what does a loan proposal look like. The exact nature of the proposals may vary depending on the subsequent clients, but the elements are generally the same. To put things in a perspective, let's consider the example of one Sanjay Salaiha, who is credited to being one of the biggest defaulters in recent history, along with being one of the biggest businessmen in the world. He owns multiple companies, some sports franchisee, and few bungalows in all major cities. Well, who is the clients? Ex-Sanjay Salaiha, reputed industrialist owning majority share in XYZ Limited and some others. Second, the quantum of credit they need and when. X starting a new airline division which would cater to the high-end segment of the society. Credit demands in closer to 25 million needed over the next 6 months. Third, the specific purpose the credit will be employed for. X acquiring of new aircrafts and capital for day-to-day operations like fuel costs, staff emoluments, airport parking charges, and etc. Fourth, ways and means to service debt obligation, which include application and processing fees, interest principals, and other statutory charges. Fifth, what protections, collateral can client provide to in the event of default? Multiple bungalows in prime locations offered as collateral along with the personal guarantees of Sanjay Salaiha was one of the most reputed businessmen in the world. What are the key areas of the business and how are they operated and monitored? That is the sixth point. Detailed reports will be provided on all key metrics related to the business. So the answer to this question helps the credit analyst to understand the broad risk associated with the proposed loan. And this question provides the very basic information about the client and helps the analyst to get a very deeper in business understanding and intrinsic risk associated with it. Now, credit analyst, he obtaining the quantitative data of the clients. Other than the above question, the analyst also needs to obtain quantitative data specific to the client. The first is borrower's history.
A brief background of the company, its capital structure, its founder, stages of development, plans for growth, list of customers, supplies, service providers, management structures, products, and all such information are exhaustively collected to form a very fair and just opinion about the company. The second is your market data, and basically the specific industry trend over here has been analyzed, the size of the market share, the assessment of the competition, competitive advantage, marketing, public relations, and any relevant future trends are studied to create a very holistic expectations of the future movements and needs. The third is that we analyze is the financial information. That is the third thing. Now, what includes? It includes the financial statements, that is the best case, expected or case, worst case, tax returns, company valuations and appraisal of assets, current balance sheets, credit references and all other similar documents which can provide an insight into the financial health of the company and are scrutinized in a very great in detail. The fourth thing that has been analyzed over here is the schedules and the exhibits. Now, Over here, certain key documents and such as like agreements with vendors and customers and insurance policies, lease agreements, pictures of the products or sites should be appended as exhibits to the loan proposal as a proof of the specifics as judged by the above mentioned indicators. It must be understood that the credit analyst, once convinced, will act as a client's advocate in presenting the application to the bank's loans committee and also guiding it through the bank's internal procedures. The details obtained are also used to finalize the loan documentation, terms, rates, and any special covenants which needs to be stipulated, keeping in mind the business framework of the client as well as the macroeconomic factors. Now, the credit analyst judgment. After collecting all the information, now the analyst has to make a real judgment regarding the different aspects of the proposal, which will be presented to the sanctioning committee. The first thing that it includes is the loan. Okay, as a part of the judgment. After understanding the need of the client, one of the many types of the loans can be tailored to suit the client's need. Amount of the money, maturity of the loan, expected use of the proceeds can be fixed depending upon the nature of the industry and credit worthiness of the company. The second is company. Now, the market share of the company, it includes, products and services offered, major suppliers, clients, competitors should be analyzed to ascertain its dependency on such factor. The third thing of analysis is credit history. Past is a very important parameter of to predict the future. So therefore, keeping in line with the conventional wisdoms, clients' past credit accounts should be analyzed to check any irregularities or defaults. So this also allows the analyst to judge the kind of the client we are dealing with, and by checking the number of times late payments were made or what penalties were imposed due to non-compliance with stipulated norms. Okay, the fourth important thing is the analysis of the market. See, analysis of the concerned market is of the utmost importance, as this helps us in identifying and evaluating the dependency of the company on external factors. Market structures, size and demand of the concerned client's product and client's product are important factors that the analysts are concerned with. The credit analyst ratio. A company's financial contains the exact picture of what business is going through, and this quantitative assessment bears the utmost significance. Analysts considers various ratios and financial instruments to arrive at this picture. What are those particular ratios which the analyst analyzes? The first is the liquidity ratios, is the first thing that they analyze. This ratio deals with the ability of the company to repay its creditors, expenses, etc. So these ratios are used to arrive at the cash generation capacity of the company. A profitable company does not imply that it will meet all the financial commitments. The second type of ratio, that is a solvability ratios. Now this ratio deals with the balance sheet items and are used to judge the future path of the company which may follow. The third is solvency ratios. Basically, in this ratios are specifically used to judge the risk involved in the business. This particular ratio takes into account the picture of the increasing amount of the debts which may be adversely affected by the long-term solvency of the company. The fourth type of the ratio that has been used is which they use for analyzing profitability ratios. And basically, this ratios show the ability of the company to earn satisfactory profit over the period of time. The fifth type of ratio is the efficiency ratios, and this particular ratios provide the insights in the management's ability to earn a return on the capital involved and the control they have on the expenses. The sixth type is close enough to cash flow and projected cash flow analysis. Now, cash flow statement is one of the most important instrument available to the credit analyst, as this helps to gauge the exact nature of the revenue and the profits flow. So this helps him to get a very true picture about the movement of the money in and out of the business. The seventh type of analysis of ratio is collateral analysis. Okay, now any security provided should be marketable, stable and transferable, because these factors are very highly important, as failure on any of these fronts will lead to complete failure of the obligation. And the last and the most thing most important is the SWOT analysis. If you have heard about it, SWOT analysis is strength, weakness, opportunity and threat. This is again the very subjective analysis which is done to align the expectations and current reality with the market condition. Now, the credit rating. The credit rating is the quantitative method using a statistical model to assess the credit worthiness based on the information of the borrower. Most banking information of the borrower, most banking institutions have their own rating mechanism. This is done to judge under which the risk category of the borrower falls. And this also helps in determining the terms and conditions of various models, use multiple quantitative and qualitative fields to judge the borrower. Many banks also use the external rating agencies like Moody's, Fitch, S&P, Standard & Poor's, which is also known as, etc., to rate the borrowers, which then forms a very important basis for consideration of the loan. What is the lesson that we have learned from Mr. Sanjay Salaiya? So let's illustrate the whole exercise with the help of an example of Mr. Sanjay Salaiya, who is a liquor baron and a hugely respected industrialist, who also happens to own a very few sports franchises and has a bungalow in the most expensive locals. He now wants to start his own airline and has therefore approached you for a loan to finance the same. The loan is for a migrate of closing up to 1 million. So as a credit analyst, we have to assess whether or not to go forward with the proposal. To begin with, we'll obtain all the required documents which are needed to understand the business model, working plan with other details of new proposal business. Necessary inspection and inquiries are undertaken to validate the veracity of the documents. A techno-economic viability can also be used to undertake to get an opinion from the experts in aviation industry about the viability of the plan. When we are satisfied with the overall efficacy of the plan, we can discuss the securities that will collaterally cover our loan, that is partly or fully. Mr. Sanjay Salaiya, being a very established industrialist, holds a very good reputation in the business world and therefore will hold very good recommendations. And such a proposal, if met, all of the aspects can be presented for sanctions comfortably and generally enjoys a very good terms from the bank side, as a risk associate with such personalities are always assessed to be less. Therefore, to conclude, Mr. Sanjay Salaiya will get a loan of $1 million approved and will go on to start his airline business. However, the future holds can never be predicted when a loan is sanctioned. Now, let's make the final conclusion on this particular note. Credit analysis is about making decisions keeping in mind the past, present and future. As a credit analyst, 2 days in life are never the same. So the role offers a plethora of opportunities to learn and understand different types of business as one engages with the multitude of the clients. Hailing from different sectors, not only is the career monetarily rewarding, but also helps individual growing along with the providing good opportunities to building one's career. Thank you.